I'm Norm Poulton, the publisher of the Business Journal, and I want to share a thought with you today. Obviously, pre-K is hot. And the latest item is we should have universal pre-K. Our president, in his State of the Union address, said we've got to make it universal for American kids. Governor Cuomo has put it in his State of the Union, State of the State message, rather, that we need pre-K throughout New York State. Mayor Minor has made it a plank in her campaign this year. And Bill de Blasio, the well-known new mayor of New York City, actually ran on this as his prime concern. Well, pre-K must be a smart thing to do. After all, we've had Head Start, which is a huge pre-K program that's been around since 1965. We're now spending $7 billion a year, or $8,000 a kid, on pre-K. And we have run a study through the Department of Human Services, Health and Human Services, a very extensive study looking at 4,667 kids spread over 23 states. And what did they conclude about pre-K? Well, while the kids aged 3 and aged 4 were in the program, they did show some improvement. As soon as they got out of the program and went into kindergarten and up through third grade, whatever advantage they had was lost compared to the control group, which had not gone through Head Start. Yes, you heard me right. The study concluded that there was no advantage to going through Head Start. The kids were no more advanced than the kids who hadn't gone through it. So what do you do when you face this situation? Well, we're told that the reason for the program is to eliminate inequality among our children so they all have an equal chance at getting ahead. That's the focus of the pre-K through Head Start. But we've proven that the program does not work. So please tell me why all of these officials are doubling down and saying, now that we have a program that doesn't work, we should make it universal. For me, it doesn't compute. If you really think that the program is critical and this is a way of giving children an equal leg up, then let's create a program that does work. Let's create a pilot program that we can actually follow and find out whether the money we're spending on it is worthwhile. It would cost a lot less than the $7 billion we're spending now. Is it possible that the concept of inequality is now up there with motherhood and apple pie, and reason has no bearing on the way we proceed? The key is spend money, emote, show that you're concerned about something, whether or not you get the results. The key for politicians is the input. It's not the outcome. For us taxpayer, unfortunately, it is the outcome because it just means more money out of our pocket for a program that frankly doesn't work. Are there any concluding thoughts that I have? Hope springs eternal. Maybe reason will finally prevail and somebody will say the emperor has no clothes. Why don't we try something different? This is Norm Poulton. Thanks for listening.